Hello children, today I am going to tell you question paper pattern. Okay, how? Because this time you will be giving the exam in written form, not objective type like you have given the last time. So I'm going to give you the question paper pattern, how the questions, what is the pattern of the questions that you will get. Okay, so look at the board. Question paper pattern, first I will tell you of English 2. So children, the question paper will be of 100 marks, okay? The total marks will be of 100. So first question will come of word meaning, okay? And then 10 out of 12. So total 12 words will be there, out of which you have to write 10 word meanings, okay? Any 10 which you know properly, you can write the meaning of any 10 word meanings. But be sure, make sure that you put the correct number of the words. Suppose you want to write 1, 2, 3, you have written word meanings, okay? And fourth one you don't know. So you want to write the fifth one. So which number you will put? 1, 2, 3 you have done. After that you will not put fourth, you will put fifth number, okay? So whichever word you are going to attempt, you will put the same question number, okay? Suppose 5, 6, 7 you have done, 8th one you don't want to do, you want to do the 9th one. So after 7th you will not write 8, sorry, you will write 9th, okay? So please don't write wrong questions. Whatever number is given in the paper, you will use as it is. I hope it is clear. And it is of 10 marks, okay? 1 mark for each word meaning. Next question is make sentences. Make sentences I have already given you. You have to learn those words and 7 will come. Okay, you have to learn all because you don't know which words are going to come. So learn all the word meanings and all the make sentences that is given to you. So any 5 you have to do out of 7. And that is also of 10 marks. And remember, when you write the sentence, you have to underline the words. Okay, suppose whatever word you are going to write sentence, you have to underline that particular word, otherwise your marks will get cut. Third is who said to whom. Okay, so this also 5 will come. This also you have got. You learn all the who said to whom that is given to you, and that will be of 10 marks. Okay, so learn it properly. Next is true false. True false also, for true false children, you have to read the chapter properly because true false will not be given to you. You have to read the chapter, all the chapters you have to read properly, and anywhere from the chapter this true false can come. Okay, so true false 5 will come, and that will be of 10 marks. So read the chapter carefully. Okay, first 8 lines of poem plus poet's name, that is of 10 marks. So you have got 3 poems. Okay, so any 2 will come, and out of those 2 you have to attempt any one poem. The first 8 lines of the poem you have to write, and please don't write like this 1, 2, 3. No, you will not write like this. You will write the poem as it is given in the book. Please don't put numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I will cut it and you will get 0 in that. Okay, that is not the way to write poem. And see all the punctuation marks which is given in the poem, where it is full stop, where it is comma, and the beginning of each sentence should be the capital letters. Okay, whatever sentence you are beginning, in each line the first letter should be of capital letter, and first you will write the name of the poem. For example, if you are going to write our classroom, okay, so first you will write our classroom, then you write the poem, and then you can write poet's name at the last. Or you can also do like this, that you will write first our classroom, just below that you can write poet's name, whatever is the poet's name you can write, and then you can write the poem. Okay, so write it properly, and please don't color the poem, don't decorate the poem, it is not asked. Okay, then question answer means the question answers which you have got in your, you have written in your copy, you have to learn all the question answers, and seven, any seven will come, out of which you have to attempt five questions. Okay, so you learn all the question answers properly, and that will be of 20 marks, means each question will be of 4 marks. Then grammar part will be of 30 marks. Okay, so grammar part means whatever book exercise which is given at the back of each chapter and poem, from that 30 marks questions will come. So you have to learn all the book exercises which is given at the back of each chapter and poem. Okay children, so I hope this question paper pattern is clear to you. If you want, you can take the screenshot of this so that it is easy for you to prepare for the exam. I hope it is clear to you, it is visible to you. Okay, so I hope you have taken the screenshot by now. So please prepare the English 2 subject properly according to this pattern. So children, I'm going to tell you the question paper pattern of English 1, that is English grammar. How you have to, which type of question paper, means what will be the pattern of the question paper, and according to that you can prepare. Before starting this, let me tell you, your English writing will also be there this time, okay? So in English writing, you write in a proper means handwriting using dark pencils, and in all the answers, children, please use dark pencils. Don't use light pencils so that nothing is visible to me, okay? So write in a neat and clean handwriting. In cursive handwriting, you will write, okay? In the writing paper, you will write in cursive handwriting, that you all know very well. So let's see the question paper pattern of English one. So first is paragraph. Okay, so you have got two paragraphs, right? My teacher, and second one you have got is Independence Day. Okay, so out of those two you have to write any one, so that will be of 10 marks. Okay, and in writing paragraph, remember to put the heading. Okay, suppose you are writing Independence Day, if you don't put the heading Independence Day, your marks will be cut. Suppose you are writing My Teacher, so you will put the heading My Teacher, and then only you will start writing the paragraph. The next is definitions. Okay, so definitions, any three you have to do, that will be of 15 marks, means each definition will be of 5 marks. And remember to write example. Okay, you can write also here, plus example. It is very important to write example. If you will not write example, your marks will get cut. Then question answers. Question answers means you have gotten two stories in your English one. One is Topsy Turvy Land, and the other is A Tale Not a Tale. Right? So Topsy Turvy Land and A Tale Not a Tale. You have to learn all the question answers which is given in those two chapters, and from there you will get question answers which will be of 10 marks. Maybe I think 4 or 5 questions may come, that will be of 10 marks. Then grammar part, means all the grammar portion which you have to do from your English 1 book. Don't leave anything, okay? And that will be of 65 marks. All the chapters will be covered, so don't skip any exercise. Please read all the exercises properly. I hope it is clear to you. Thank you.